Good afternoon everyone, it's Ian from DIY Home and Gardening. Whilst the weather's on my side, as in not raining, we're going to try and get a couple of videos done. So we are into middle of November now, so perfect timing to start on pruning back your roses and a lot of more perennial things. But yeah, video today I'm going to show how to prune your roses ready for winter. And then a little knock on or side video to that, which is how to take rose cutting. So yeah, let me turn the camera around and show you how to do it. Well, this is the rose in question that I'm going to do today. Rose Mum in a Million, fantastic flowering variety. Yeah, still got the original label there. A lot of you probably would have, well, hopefully a lot of you have seen it in my monthly sort of looking good calendar videos, whatever you want to call them, because it's just been doing its stuff for such a long time. And indeed, you know, middle of November, it's trying to produce a bit of flower, albeit it's got a bit of aphid as well. Anyway, this is the time to sort of do a bit of pruning to the roses. We don't go total prune back at this time of year, but it's always a good practice to cut back ready for winter. The traditional thing has always been to reduce the height by about half, just to prevent what was called wind rock, and then you do your main pruning in about the January February time, when the plant was in total dormancy. But like I say, mid-November, perfect to do some pruning. And the other reason to do a bit of pruning now is because you'll be able to use these nice semi-ripened stems for cutting material. And so that is going to be another video that I'm going to do today. So let me set the camera up, get the tripod all geared up, and then start doing some pruning and kind of show you how to do it. Right then, first things first, get some gloves on. It's not the most spiteful rose in the world, but yeah, just put a pair of gloves on, just protect yourself. Get your secateurs. So I mean, these are my old Felcos, because my others are, well, currently in pieces. But yeah, I've given these a clean up and sharpen this morning, so they're good to go. Right. So the first thing you want to do, spend a little time, just have a look at it, see what you need to do. So first things first, you want to remove any stuff like that. So your D's, dead, diseased or damaged material. So that's what you're removing first. So that's nice and simple, we can do that. So you literally work your way, having a look through. And you can do it as simply as that, just work your way around, concentrate on those bits to start with. You're also looking to unclog the middle bit. So see how we've got this congested center to it. So what happens there is you're ending up with all the branches are coming inwards. It's going to become very congested for next season and subsequent years if you don't remove those, and with lack of airflow, increases the amount of pest and disease problems that you're going to get. So we want to open up the middle. So again, with roses in particular and a lot of pruning, you want to end up with this nice open goblet shape. So that's what we're looking to do. And then thirdly, the bits you're going to be removing, these spindly pieces like this. So again, really, any stems that are thinner than about pencil thickness, really, those bits you're going to be looking to remove. But as I said, we're into middle of November, so at the moment we're concentrating on bringing down the height and a little bit of remedial work, because any proper pruning you're going to be tackling a little bit later, later in the winter. So let's get going on this. When you're doing your pruning, look to where your buds are. So that is essentially where these leaves have sprouted from. and there is where a bud is, and that's where it will then produce a new shoot from next year when it starts growing. What we want to do, again, to preserve this open centre, prune to an outward facing bud, so a bud that's coming away from the centre. So nice and simple. That one's already been pruned, but we can have a look, prune that out, because we don't want that. Follow this down, so that's outward, outward, inward, but still too high, outward, perfect sort of height. So prune that, make your cut slightly sloping so that any water that lands on it, any rain, is going to slightly slope away. It's not going to be sitting flat on the top and getting down and causing some rot. So let's carry on. So again, where you're unsure, outward, inward, outward there, which will be suitable. So sloping cut, and we can work our way around, cut down your plant to that kind of height. So what is that? That's probably 20 inches, should we say 20 inches? So one and three quarter feet, something like that. So about 45-50 centimeters in height. So that's what we'll cut down to, and that's our height for this time of year. So we'll just work our way around, outward facing buds, and we can, this makes it a little bit easier for us because it's going to reduce a bit of this top congestion, make it easier so we can actually see what we're getting into before we worry about doing too much. Nearly got sidetracked there. I'm kind of doing this a bit more, I suppose, simply than I normally would, as I'm trying to show all you lot the methods, I suppose. So even on some of this spindly growth, I will cut it back because I'll just show you how we're going to end up. Outward facing, inward facing, inward facing, outward facing. Work our way around still, always to your outward facing. Pick off your leaves as you're going, take off any dead, diseased, damaged material. So it's important, I always take off the leaves this time of year as well, that way you're not going to end up with any leaves dropping to the ground. Likewise, once you finish, collect up any leaves, because you will notice where you get a little bit of spotting, so whether that's from black spot or powdery mildew, the leaves have dropped to the ground, the spores will then fall off the leaf, sit in the soil, and then when you get to next season, once it starts warming up again and you've started already to get these nice fresh shoots and leaves on, the warm air will then pull all the spores through evaporation. It'll cause them to come up into the air straight onto the new leaves, and hey presto, you'll end up with black spot and mildew problems again. So that's what we do, you know, it's good husbandry, as they say. Outward facing, and outward facing. So you can see we've brought the height down, that's the first challenge. Now start looking to see how you can open it up a little bit. Again, bear in mind you're not going to be doing too much pruning, or don't go crazy at this time of year, because you'll be saving your proper pruning for the springtime. And also, what also happens in the spring, nearly tipped over, is you will find that you'll get an element of dieback on some of the shoots. So you just want to go around, keep it tidy, and it's really to prevent this getting blown around too much and getting the roots damaged. So for the time being, we'll keep it simple. We'll thin out a little bit where we want to, or where we can. Any obvious problems, we can snip out. And you're just looking to, say, slightly open up this centre stem here, where you can see that you've got a wraparound piece, and also this to an extent, where you can snip that off because you've still got your stem there, it's no problem. This piece here is going to cause rubbing, so in that instance you can come slightly lower. And again with these pieces, cut them out. Secateurs are nice and sharp, so it means that you haven't got to be jabbing in like that. Move your wrist. Your wrist rotates quite comfortably to accommodate the different positions. Do your pruning, work your way around. So again, slightly different. Nice open structure. And really, that's as much as we need to do for our winter pruning. And we'll do the rest of the pruning, as I say, once we get to January, February time, when it's nice and cold and the rose has gone into proper dormancy. Oh, miss those little bits. And then get in there, collect up any of this leaf debris from the roses, get rid of that. So that can all go, and that's your winter pruning done. Job done, finished, move on to your next one. And yeah, so all there is to it, nice and simple. And there you have it, nice simple job to get done for the autumn. Roses pruned, that's it, it's as easy as that. So get out there, go and do your own roses, and then go put the kettle on, get warmed up, and see you in January, February when we carry on doing the rose prune. Bye for now.